In terms of finances, yeah, so young people living in an expensive city is a difficult place to be. We're in Toronto and it's much the same. You're getting started in life and you've got school debt and you've got bills and you've got, you know, you're not in your prime earning years and all of that. And in that context, it's very, very easy to get in the habit of not giving or to refuse to build the habit of giving. And I don't think the Lord allows us to not give. Maybe if you are absolutely, you're not doing anything, you're only buying the cheapest stuff, you're not doing anything else, then okay, maybe you could talk to the elders or deacons in your church and say, what do I do? But I mean, if you're drinking Starbucks and you're, as most people are, and you're just, you've got money for other things, and you say, I can't afford to give anything. Well, you can, right? And it ought to be a great joy to be giving. It's not meant to be a burden. But you don't get to know the joy until you've experienced the joy. And to experience the joy, you actually have to experience the giving. It really is more blessed to give than to receive, right? There is true joy in giving to the work of the Lord. The joy doesn't come because you necessarily see, I gave that dollar and it went here and it accomplished this. The joy comes through obedience. You're being obedient to the Lord and the Lord just gives you joy in your giving. You get to experience that. It really is a blessing to be able to give. It's also a sign of gratitude, right? Not giving is ingratitude. You're saying to the Lord, you've given this to me, and instead of expressing my thanks for your provision in giving back, I'm holding on to it. That's a lack of gratitude. There's a reason that we're thank offerings, right? To express thanks to God. So you're denying yourself many blessings if you refuse to give. Not only that, but you may, on the opposite side, be asking God to chasten you in some way, right? Which God does just as a parent chastens their child who has been disobedient. God does that to us. So it is a joy to give. It's a joy to know you've given, a joy to be able to thank God as you give and to experience the blessings of that.